This week, I have been mostly polishing ammonite.
Welcome back, fossil lovers. Polishing fossils is a great fun little thing you can do using only a bit of elbow grease and wet and dry sandpaper. You want loads of different grades. I go from 150 all the way up to 5,000. You can go a bit lower, but the higher you can go, the better you can get. You can achieve results like this. With a lot of hard work, this one was started at 50 grit, then up to 80 grit and 120 grit and so on. That was a lot of work. I like to leave the other side natural as is. This was given just a very fine little buff using a very high grade wet and dry, just to try and keep it au naturel. Now I like to not overly buff, and this one was started on 600 and went up to 7,000. This one I have gone both sides, but usually I like to just do one side. So I'm going to take a dry old ammonite like this and bring it up to something like this. In very little time and for very little money. So all you need is your wet and dry sandpaper, a little pot to get them wet, and a bottle of water. Usually I do this outside in the garden, but it's raining today, and not everybody has access to outside, so you can just do it inside. So you want to get your fossil wet. There's a little soapy water in that as well. Soap just helps give it a nice little bit of lubrication and makes the water wetter. You'll keep your wet and dry sandpaper nice and wet as well. And when you find them, they're usually wet and they look like that, beautiful. So we're just going to give one side a nice buff down just to give it that wet look back. It's already pretty smooth from the sea, so I'm going to start at 150. If your ammonite's rougher and you've got deeper gouges in it, start at 80. So you want to move, constantly be moving and getting the ammonite wet, so that you're not building scratches or making marks all in one place. This is where you want to be doing most of your work. You want to spend most of your time doing the bottom grades to get rid of all the scratches and imperfections. Personally, I quite like the imperfections, so I won't buff this down too heavily, but just enough to get us going. You'll always be changing the direction of your ammonite. It just helps to make sure that you're not always buffing in the same spot. Always lubricating. And keep going until it starts feeling easy, I usually find. As soon as it starts feeling a bit easier, then you know it's done with that grade. Got the toothbrush here just to make sure you get all the bits of sandpaper or bits of ammonite that have come off, because you don't want to be rubbing them down with the next grade. Give it a little wash off. Now you want to give it a dry off. So for the purpose of this video, I'm going to try a bit more 80 grit sandpaper just to take away some of these little dinks from where it's been smashed about in the sea. I'm going to have to give just normal sandpaper a go because I've run out of lower grade wet and dry. I'll just reuse this water because that's a higher grade anyway. It's holding up better than that wet and dry so far. Always make sure that you're keeping the ammonite and the wet and dry sandpaper well lubricated. Well, that was definitely worth going back down a grade, down to the 80 grit sandpaper, and the old 80 grit normal sandpaper held up pretty well. It's worth taking your time on the lower grades to get rid of all the imperfections and try and get out of any deep scratches. There was a couple of deep ones here, so don't ever be tempted to skip a grade. Try and go up all the grades that you've got. So we're gonna go back in for the 150, get our ammonite wet, get our paper wet. Now I've dried the ammonite out with a cloth. It's still slightly wet because you can never get it properly dry with a cloth. You want to dry it each time and just check, make sure you've got rid of all the little scratches and marks and that you're happy with what you've done with that grade of sandpaper. This looks pretty good. Done pretty well just using the 80 and the 150. We've taken our time with the lower grades now. We can smash it through the higher grades a bit quicker. Make sure you change your water each time because you don't want to be taking particles of the rougher sandpaper because that will just damage your finer next layer. I'm going to crack on. Going to want to be a 240. Not quite a trip to the dentist. Whack on the time lapse. I've left the ammonite to dry for an hour or so. I've just been to the shop and picked up my nipper from school. So we know this is perfectly dry now. It's already starting to get a nice little shine to it. You can see it's absolutely perfect, no scratches. Maybe a little there, but along here, this part in here is not going to polish great because we've got this harder stone matrix stuff. And as we're polishing, this is coming off and affecting the polish because it's rougher than the wet and dry that we're using. So this has just been up to 600 so far. Now we're going to move up to the 1000. I've got these little sponge pads I'm using now. These are just what I've got. These are, in my opinion, much better than the paper. These last a lot longer and are easier to hold and everything. They're almost there. We'll get it back on with a time lapse, a bit more clean water, and off we go. Beautiful sutras there. Look at them. Absolutely fantastic. Always remember to keep your ammonite and wet and dry paper lubricated. The steps get missed in the time lapse because it's so quick you miss it. So in very little time we've taken a beach worn ammonite and polished that into an absolute gem. Look at that. No waxes on that, no polishing compounds, nothing. This is just wet and dry sandpaper. Could have stopped at 2000, but the extra couple of grades just gives you that amazing glass finish. Stunning, look at those chambers filled with calcite. See the beautiful oak leaf pattern from the suture lines of the phragmocone here. Obviously the centre's a bit harder to get into. But yeah, from that dry old ammonite. Bing! Beautiful. Hope you liked the video. If you haven't already and you've just joined the channel, please like and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the notification bell for more adventures, tips and tricks. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.